I'm kind of dreading, gonna have wet feet and everything because it was raining the past few days, but wish me luck. Let's pack and go. Listening to much anyway. Now comes my least favorite part of this walk. It's the mud ramp. So I haven't been on a walk so long, a long hike like this. I almost forgot it's something I do. I go on like regular walks, like two kilometers, maybe sometimes four, but like a long walk like this, like 8+ kilometers, it's been a while. I remember Jesse Driftwood saying something or tweeting something along the lines I'm a hobby collector. I think everyone's like that a bit. Like that for me too. Like there's so many things that you used to have as a hobby and you just forget to do them, and at one point it becomes something you used to do, you don't do anymore. Like I remember I used to regularly go rock climbing, like bouldering, mostly indoors. Yeah, it's a thing I did fairly often a few years ago, and at one point my rock climbing buddy moved to Berlin, and after that it just faded off. I did it like two or three times after that, but it just went away. Another hobby that just left me. Not entirely. I mean, I still do like little finger trainings and stuff, but like I haven't been to a rock climbing bouldering thing in so long. I don't even know if I have the strength and stuff to do it still. But yeah, that's one hobby that fell by the wayside. I think hobby number two that fell by the wayside was painting miniature models, like little plastic figurines. There's like tabletop games like Warhammer 40K, which I used to play. And then you have like these little plastic figurines and you can give them a real cool paint job. I was never super good at it, but it was fun, and it was something I used to do together with my wife, but we both painted those. She was better at it than me, I'm pretty sure. It was a cool hobby, but like getting back into it is quite an extensive thing to do right now. A little bit expensive maybe too, but like you have to buy all the paints and new brushes, and we still have lots of those models. That's not the problem. Still have a lot of unpainted ones just sitting in a closet. Just could never get rid of them. Keep telling myself one day you'll go back to it. Who knows? Maybe it's just another collected hobby. Buying all those paints. It's like, I think it was a year ago or something, I decided like, hey, still have all those models and those paints. Let's crack them all out. Open one of those pots up and that paint bucket's dry. Try the next one. Also dry. They were all dry. Except for like one red color that was off-brand. Wasn't the original Warhammer brand. That one was still good. It had a screw-on lid in a glass. That one was still golden. The rest dried up as hell. But yeah, then I put that back. And now they're collecting dust in a closet again. I think another habit that's going away from me is probably just watching TV. I mean, so seldom that I'll actually sit down in front of a TV and watch a show or a movie. I don't know if people call that a hobby or just a habit you do every day, but yeah, like watching TV. Like we haven't even hooked up anything like that for ages. And by ages, I mean like 10 plus years. And I mean, I still watch some series now and then. That's all on the computer. Most things I watch are on YouTube these days. That's like a, I don't know, 45 minutes, an hour daily maybe. And I'm watching stuff on YouTube, unless it's watching meme compilations together on Discord streams. That's another story. Those can take hours. You know, it's not always a bad thing. When you give up one hobby, you usually pick up another. That's why you don't have time for the old ones, or you don't do the old ones as much. So, I mean, I've picked up other hobbies. I occasionally go wakeboarding, like once or twice a year. It's regular. What's more regular is like making videos. Didn't used to do that. So that's a fun thing. And I think this is also a cool place to record another silent walk. I really like how that lane goes down there. Usually just do it with my phone. I like the stabilization that it has when I'm walking. Very good for that. Also saves me the vlogging camera battery. Not as hard to hold it either, because this thing can get quite heavy over many minutes like that. So, but before we do that, just notice someone built like a shelter or a roof thing here. That hasn't been here. Last time I looked, I'm not sure what this thing is for. Maybe it's just for funsies or for drying wood in the forest. I'm no expert, but good craftsmanship, I guess. Looks well made. Wood tiles. Those are gonna age well. Halfway in, it's like the 4 kilometer mark. I'm gonna take a little break. You know, some hobbies you don't lose them forever. You just put them on hold. They're meant to ferment a bit. Like, I don't know, sometimes you go back to an old hobby and it just feels like nostalgia. It feels good again. And you like doing it. like, kind of like bike riding. Like when I was 14 to 18, I would ride my bike probably almost every evening, like 30K. And I stopped doing it for a long time, like moving out to college and starting a job and stuff. And then got back into it, I'd say like late 20s, early 30s, or somewhere around there. Yeah, it was fun getting back into it. It was some nostalgia in there, but it was also cool. You know, I had a little more money due to I had a job now, and then I could afford better equipment. It was more fun. You know, hobby, sometimes you put it on ice and it comes back. And I'm kind of doing that right now again, like with the bike riding, like with the kids and everything. I don't go as regularly as I used to. I gotta like choose my time between kids, family, work, and everything, and video games. But I do that at night, like right now. It gets dark way too early, and I don't want to be speeding around in the dark. Can't see shit, run over stuff, break a leg. Ain't got no time for that. Ain't nobody got time for that. Don't beat yourself up about it. I mean, some hobbies, you did them, you had fun, and you let them rest, and that's it. And the other ones, you're just, you know, you're gonna come back to them one day. Time to get moving again. Some hobbies you're just meant to grow out of, I guess, like the things you do as a kid, and you mostly do them because, you know, you did it with your friends, and like you don't do that shit anymore because you feel you're too old for it, or it just doesn't give you the same level of fun anymore. That's ultimately the best thing about a hobby. It's something you do for fun, purely, mostly purely for fun. Some people combine it, work and hobby, but it's like purely, mostly fun, isn't it? The way that branch got perfectly caught on the tree though. Quite cool. I mean, as a kid, I collected a lot of trading cards and read a lot of comic books. Don't do much of that anymore. Some people still do. I'm not saying it's a kid hobby, just something I enjoyed more as a kid. Now I like to read other things, and trading cards aren't a thing I'm into as much anymore. Still have some of my old ones. Check out what they're worth. I don't know if I would sell them, but nice to know if they have some good keepers in there. Back in the day, kids, before we had NFTs, we had trading cards. Remember that. That's what your NFTs are based out. We ain't had no fancy cryptocurrency wallets. So if you hear people yodeling in the background, it's because they're hunting. And I guess they yodel whatever they're yodeling towards guys standing that way. They're yodeling from over there. Yodeling the animals towards him, I guess. I'm pointing his rifle with a scope into the woods that direction. Not sure what they're hunting. I'm guessing deer. Poor fuckers. So yeah, I mean, keep your hobbies being a hobby, because that's what keeps them fun. Gunshots in the background. And then there's also like hobbies you want to take up. Things you're interested in that you might think are a cool hobby. Try it out in little steps first. You may find that you have invested too much already into the hobby and you don't really like it that much. So don't think, yeah, I want to play an instrument and then buy guitar and amp and three sets of strings and all the fancy bells and whistles and five paddles and shit, and then you're half a year into it and you realize, yeah, I haven't done this much and I don't really enjoy it much. I don't have all this capital investment into this hobby. Make you have a bad conscience about it. So take it small. Do it in small incremental steps. Iteration is the key, baby. So yeah, keep that in mind. You want to take up a hobby? Test the waters first. Never hurts to just try something out. The more you do it this way, just take things in little test runs, the broader of experience you'll have, and you can find out what you like the most. It's kind of like how you should handle like career choices. If you're in your 20s or something, don't be afraid to switch jobs and try something else. You can always bounce back to what you were doing before. Like broaden your horizon, try other jobs. Maybe you like them, maybe you'll find out that was all shit and I want to go back to what I was doing. But you'll be the wiser and you'll have the experience to tell you. You won't be guessing, what if I did? Instead you'll be, I tried and I know I didn't like it, so I'm happy where I am right now. So yeah, that's how you should approach things. It's not just with hobbies, you can do it with your career advice. Oh, like lots of things in life. Just try them out a bit first. Like some new food. You don't know if you're into it or not. Don't buy a fucking year supply of something if you haven't even tried the food yet. Try a little bit first, huh? That's another hobby I gave up. Playing a bass guitar. when I was in college and before that, around, I think around 18 or 19, somewhere around there, I started playing bass. Got a little amp and a starter bass guitar for Christmas from my mom one day. And yeah, played that until, and I played regularly like into college, and then sort of was in a band, in two bands, three bands maybe. Actually, I think I started playing before I was 18. I was playing with friends and shit already. But yeah. So I guess there is a, yeah, a sign from this side. No sign from the side I came from. I guess I just wandered through the fucking crossfire zone. Fucking mint, I survived. And without a yellow vest or anything, because I'm like blackout, except for my shoes. I'm surprised I still have dry and warm feet, given I'm walking these barefoot shoes. But yeah, would expect it to have wet and cold feet by now. But so far they're keeping me dry, even though it is relatively muddy today. But like usually when it's just a little bit wet, they get like a little soggy on the top. Should wax them maybe and make them a little more winter re-preparedness, or just wear boots. But I like these, they're so comfy. And yeah, it's part of what makes this hobby feel good. Just, it's almost like walking barefoot. This, on the outskirts of town, is where a Jewish cemetery used to be before the Nazi era. It was destroyed during that time of the Third Reich in Germany. There's a monument there now to commemorate what had happened there. So, if you made it this far, tell me in the comments, like, what hobbies have you abandoned? What hobbies are you looking to take up? Just aren't sure yet if you want to get into them. Leave me a comment. Oh, by the way, we have new pets. They're not our pets, but this dude comes and visits our garden a lot. Cock-a-doodle-doo, right, dude? Feed you seeds. Look what you dinosaurs turn into. Well, thanks for tuning in. If you made it this far, really appreciate it. It's time to do some more family man things. Gotta bring some kiddos to bed. And time to edit this video. So see ya. Thanks for sticking around. See you in the next one.